in the yeshiva, and the next thing they see is that the person put on tefillin shel rosh with the box on, like this, and he's standing there, right? And they take him, mazal tov, huh? No, shaliach, the hand, Baruch Hashem, he had enough in his hand to take off the box of the hand. So everybody
was told. The halacha is,
if a person puts on tefillin with their boxes, or somebody puts on tefillin in the wrong place, he did not fulfill his obligation, he has to go back and put on his tefillin again. Okay? Shel Rosh, the person who put on Shel Rosh with the box on, so and then he started praying, so what he's supposed to do is take off his tefillin Shel Rosh, take off the box, put on tefillin Shel Rosh with the beracha al mitzvah tefillin. It's a must. Because he's not Yotzei Yedei Chova. You have to make sure, Shel Yad is, if you put on with the box, you have to take it off and put it on again with the beracha. עוד פעם, אם ברכה, לא יצא ידי חובה, הוא לא עשה מה שצריך לעשות. He did not do what he said he was going to do.
למה לא אמרת לי את זה אתמול?
I did not see you wearing a box, I'm sorry.
לא ראית אותי?
לא ראיתי אותך שם box.
הוא לא היה פה אתמול.
היה. לא קרה בתורה, מה קרה לך?
לא תוכל.
Somebody is smoking something here. Okay. Lo chashuv. Okay. Whatever it is. Here we are going to go through some important halachot. This is a reproof. This is a reproof to some people who tend to speak during tefillah. First of all, you're supposed to be careful not to say anything else but tefillah. That is number one. The Ben Ish Chai brings down a famous story. They say on Shabbat, there was a person who lived in Baghdad. He used to say tefillin from beginning till the end. So Shabbat Achad, one Shabbat, he was sitting, he was saying his tehillim. In the middle of the tehillim, came to him some no good friends, and they started to antagonize, instigate, bother him. So he, in the middle of his tehillim, he said a few nice words to them, what not. That Shabbat, when he went to sleep in the afternoon, came to him two angels, black ones, Shcholim, they came to him, and they started saying, they opened in front of him the Tehillim, and they told him, read the Tehillim. As he's reading through the Tehillim, he found in the middle of his Tehillim, where he stopped, what his friend said to him, what he answered back to them, and what not, and at the end they told him, Chaton, sign. So he, in his dream, out of fear, took a pen and he signed, say, I so and so, said Tehillim, tak, 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 and he wrote whatever he wrote. And then these two guys grabbed the Tehillim and they ran away. They said, we're going to Beit Din Shel Malach. Oy! This guy woke up from his sleep. He woke up from his sleep sweating.
Yo.
Sweating. Scared. He ran to the Beit Din Shel Malach, asked him what to do. The Beit Din Shel Malach told him, you have to do Teshuvah. So, Keborok Akpoto, he told him, next time you say Tehillim, you have to make sure you have to fix the problem. And you have to give him a tikkun the whole way, what to do and how to do. And you have to make sure you have no interruptions at all. This is a true story, not something to play around with. Talking, in general, you have to watch the nablut peh. The bad, the improper speech is not allowed at all. Asu be'echlet. And then, talking during tefillah is not a preferable thing to do at all. Especially from Baruch She'amar, once you start saying Pesukei DeZimra, for all the way till after Shmona Esre, till after the Chazrat Hashatz, you're not allowed to say an extra word. No comments, no hints, nothing. Talking to the Bono Shel Olam, you're talking to Hashem, not allowed to talk. It's Asur. The Halacha in Shulchan Aruch says, anybody speaks, Goalim Bo. They used to yell at him, say, what is this? Give it to him. Not a joke. Okay. Interruptions are not allowed. It goes so far. If let's say I'm saying my pesukei dezimra and I go on saying all the tefillot, there are certain things even that they normally I would want to answer to, I'm not allowed to. For example, let's say I'm in the middle of the brachot of Yotzel Or, in the middle of Shema Yisrael, in the middle of the brachot of Gaar Yisrael, I'm not allowed to answer amen to every single thing. Let's say I hear my friend, I'm saying, Yotzer Or Borei Choshech, and my friend says, Baruch Atah Hashem, Elokeinu Melech HaOlam, Shehakol Nehiyah B'Dvaro. I cannot answer amen. I'm not allowed to. מה הם saying הברכה? יוצר אור ובורא חושך קדוש, 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 קדוש. And my friend says, ברוך אתה השם שהכל נהיה בדברו. הנה עליו תעצת איש ברכה. It's called an interruption. The only thing I'm allowed to answer is קדיש, five amen, חצי קדיש. Not even a full קדיש. Let's say I...
מדור after, weird.
Sorry. No. We're gonna have to repeat this again. Hey, so he says over there that you're only allowed to answer חצי קדיש, not more. חצי קדיש, not more. Even as מחלוקת הפוסקים, יהא שמי רבה, מברך דעלם, נעמי עלמיה, יתברך. Do I start by יתברך, or do I go till דעמירם בעלמה? To say 28 words. Is that what I'm allowed to do? מחלוקת הפוסקים. So Acham Avadia says you're supposed to go till יתברך and not more. Not allowed to say more words. We're talking about praising ריבונו של עולם. A person is obligated to say מודים אנחנו לך. שאתה right to say מודים with the ציבור. And here he is, he's playing. יוצר אור ובורא חושך. סני חזד את מחזיר שכינתו לציון. No, he's not allowed to answer amen. And the 18, he's listening to חזרת השץ. He's only allowed to answer two amens only. הקל הקדוש. And שומע תפילה. That's it. מודים אנחנו לך, just say, מודים אנחנו לך. And that's it. No more. Not allowed to interrupt. Some people, this is the halacha I wanted to get to. When they say, write the Kriyat Shema Shema Yisrael. They finish Shema Yisrael. Hashem Elok, Ani Hashem Elokechem, Asher Otzet Yedchem Meretz Mitzrayim, Liyot Lachem Lelokim, Hashem Elokechem, Ani Hashem Elokechem, he's supposed to say Emet. Now when he says Emet, and then the Chazan says, Ani Hashem Elokechem Emet, he's not allowed to answer Emet anymore. A lot of people, they think that, you know, Emet, 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 yeah, sure, sure, Emet. One time. If you said it yourself already, Hashem Elokechem Emet, you are finished. Don't make interruptions, you're not allowed to. When the Chazan says Hashem Elokechem Emet, okay, so he said Hashem Elokechem Emet. And then you go on. If you finish Shema before he finishes, and you said your Emet, you are done. And when he says Hashem Elokechem Emet, you don't have to say Emet. We don't say Emet two times, three times, one time. You said it, either you say it together with him, Ani Hashem Elokechem, and we say Emet, one loud Emet, or if you did it separately, don't say Emet anymore. Don't say it twice, not supposed to say it twice, one time only, one time. This is the halacha, very important, do not to say this.
But Yachid,
what he does is, he says, Ani Hashem Elokechem, Emet, Hashem Elokechem Emet, some say to say, and then go v'yatziv v'nachon v'kayam v'yashar. But he's not allowed to say his own, Ani Hashem Elokechem Emet. Now he's waiting. Chazan says, Ani, right? He says, he's not allowed to answer Emet to him anymore. Finished, he's done. There's a limit. One time only. Atkan. Okay? We don't have many untouchable. People already ran off.